Okay, so it's kind of almost official at this point. Pete Thamel's reporting that Jeff Lebby is accepting the head coaching position at Mississippi State. Just reported literally a few minutes ago as I'm recording this around 5:43 p.m. Eastern. So, looks like that's happening. I mean, that's been in the people would talk about for a while. We're just kind of waiting for something official with the fiasco with A&M last night happening going on with like Mark Stoops allegedly taking the job, and then that was pulled out from under the rug from out from under them at the 11th hour. And now Mike Elko of Duke is going to take that job, supposedly. Gonna wait and see what happens there. But yeah, Jeff Lebby gone after 2 years. And I'm sure there'll be some mixed reactions from people. I know some people are like, thank God he's gone. We did have the number four offense in the country. So there is that. It wasn't the worst thing in the world, but I said before, I just think at the end of the day, Lebby was not going to be the guy to lead us to offensive, prowess in the SEC. I just think there at some point there needed to be a change. There was also the incident with his father-in-law earlier this year. I'm sure that ruffled some feathers, but they were professionals and they moved on to the rest of the year. And we got to 10 wins, and it wasn't always easy, but we got there. So again, like Seth Luttrell's a guy people are talking about. He's already on the staff. Maybe he takes over, but I think you'll still have to find a quarterback coach. Because that's the position that Lebby was kind of taking control of as well. So you might have to find two people instead of just one. But again, the really hotshot recruiters on the staff, we still got Emmett Jones, DeMarco's still good, Beatonbow's still good. I know some people are worried potentially about losing Jackson Arnold, and Jackson's not going to go anywhere. His dad, he's at OU, he's staying at OU. I know people are worried about like Davon Mitchell and things like that. I'm not sweating these things right now. I think that's more of a head coaching thing that really affects things. That affects the whole program. When listen, Davon Mitchell, he knows he's gonna get lots of snaps. He's an early enrollee, like coming in January. So if he changed his mind last second, God bless him. He was meant to go do greater things, but he gonna get lots every opportunity to play next year. I promise you that. So. But again, just I have mixed emotions about it. Like, there's part of me that's like, good, he's gone. But the other has like, yeah, when his offense was humming, it was humming, man. It worked. It was a well-oiled machine. But at the same time, he would always stall. And like, listen, it's part of this is that we're spoiled when it comes to offensive football as of late. The insanity we've seen on offense with this program, with the quarterbacks. We're so used to being boom, 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 like the highest powered offense in the country, but we don't have a defense to back it up. And so, like, at the end of the day, you're like number four in the nation. People would kill for that. So it's just, but there was just a bunch of little things here and there that drove you nuts. And who knows how things would have turned out if you stayed. But you're always going to replace assistants. You're always going to replace coordinators as part of the game. Nick Saban replaces guys every couple of years. He's the GOAT. So you have to adjust and move on. So I'm not going to let the decision of a 17 or 18 year old ruin my day or ruin my weekend. If anything comes from that, I'm not saying anything's imminent. But if y'all looking at Twitter and sharing tweets of certain commits saying things, it's going to drive you insane. Don't allow that to happen. I promise you. The holidays are coming up. I'm sure some of you have enough stress already as is. So, but yeah, going to next year, we'll see how things turn out and who we go with. I'm sure there's like I said, Seth Luttrell's name's popped up on staff, but we'll see if we do a search. I'm not sure yet. So, we don't have a game next Saturday. So, whoever we get to likely to. I don't know who's going to call plays in San Antonio, mind you, because that's probably where we're going. I know people think we're going to a New Year's Six. Don't get your hopes up for that. Just telling you, do not do that. You will be disappointed. But that's really about it. I can talk about like our time in the Big 12. I'll save that for another video. I might save that for tomorrow, just for something to talk about. But we're done with the Big 12. It's over. Granted, other sports, we still got basketball and softball and stuff like that. But it's different one for it feels different for football. Like, we're done with the Big 12, period. It is over. So I'll share my thoughts on that at some point. But Lebby's out the door. Wish him well. Because despite all the ups and downs, we had some really good memories. Like, called a really great game. That last drive against Texas, I will always be thankful for that because I was there in person and got to see something magical. So, love or hate Lebby, and a lot of people you've hated on him this year, we'll we got to see some magic happen this year on some level. So I'll always appreciate that. So go on, Jeff. Do great things at Mississippi State. Unless you're playing OU, I hope you lose. And we'll see what happens down the road. So anything pops up that's noteworthy, I'll be here to talk about it. So like, subscribe, comment, all those good things YouTubers say. Leave a super thanks if you appreciate the channel. I really appreciate all the support all year. It's been a really fun year. A lot better than last year. So, but again, we'll see what I could. I'm still planning to do my playoff watch along in a month or so. I keep saying I'm never going to do it again, but I always do. I don't know if I'm going to do a watch along for this weekend. We'll see. Maybe the SEC title game, maybe not. Not going to do the Big 12 championship game. That's for damn sure. But with that, I will catch you all later. Boomer Sooner.